All right. Yeah. Mindy Cabrera says, I'm looking for an informed opinion on the use of pregnenolone to manage perimenopausal symptoms, particularly insomnia, which I get early in my cycle and mid-cycle. It seems to help, but I don't feel confident in using it. Anything else would be better? Anything else that would be better for GnRH-induced insomnia?
Well, so here's the thing about pregnenolone. So oral or sublingual, so if you've got drops or little tablets you suck on, pregnenolone and progesterone, when they go through first pass, so you swallow them, and then go through first pass, they turn into other metabolites. One is called Allo, A-L-L-O, which is short for allopregnanolone. Allo binds to your GABA receptors in your brain. Allo can cross the blood-brain barrier, binds to GABA. GABA, of course, is your calming, relaxing, everything's going to be okay hormone. So pregnenolone and oral progesterone actually work on the anxiety and on the insomnia from a GABA point of view,
if it's not oral, do you know is there normally endogenous allopregnanolone?
Yeah.
GABA receptors.
Yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely. Oh yeah, your body makes it. Mm-hmm. Yep. And it's a neurosteroid, so your brain makes it, and then the breakdown of progesterone can turn into allo, and that can cross the blood-brain barrier. So you make it yourself in the brain. But as women, especially if you are headed into perimenopause, you're not ovulating. You're not getting that robust progesterone peak in the luteal phase. It falls close to your period, and now in the early part of your follicular phase, then it you're hurting because you've missed out. You didn't get any of that sustained progesterone release that turned into allo, and insomnia is really common around the cycle and really common in perimenopause, right? I would say, other than weight gain, I would say insomnia is probably the other big symptom I hear for perimenopause. And that's a big one.